The influx of asylum seekers now living in our area, many organizations are reaching out to help in any way they can. And one of those organizations is the Catholic Charities of the Archdiocese of New York. The staffers there are looking for volunteers to help welcome asylum seekers. And joining us this morning is Tessa Graham and Christina Perez from the Catholic Charities of the Archdiocese of New York. I can't remember, Christina, and I'll start with you, the last time the Catholic Charities has put out a call for volunteers to come help. I don't know how long you've been with the organization, but is this the first time where you can remember such a clarion call that says, in order to help you, we need help ourselves?
You are absolutely correct. So I've been with Catholic Charities for now 5 years, and we've never seen a need as great as it is now. With everything that has happened since August, we're in a cycle that is unending, and we absolutely need volunteers to come in and to help support our teams and give that compassion and love with dignity and respect that Catholic Charities uphold for all who come to our doors.
Help and support the teams, Tessa. What do the volunteers do to help and support the teams?
Well, when they arrive, the first thing they offer is love. So we embrace the families that come from all types of pathways. And the second thing they offer is respect. So we make sure that as they come, they're respected, they're heard. And the third thing we offer is embracing them and embracing the fact that sometimes they just want to share their experience with us, right? And know that at the end of it all, there's growth, right? And a lot of times the message that we get from the families is that, wow, we feel like we have hope now. So there's this esperanza, right? Hope in Spanish, that they share with us, and that right there is you know, the embracing all that is what we offer.
Christina, is there training? If I'm watching Tiempo and I say, okay, I want to be a volunteer, do you help them find out what to do and how?
Absolutely. So right now we are taking in volunteers to do everything from guiding our volunteers to certain locations, welcome orientations, helping assembling kits, translations, and anybody who wants to come in through our doors, you want to start tomorrow, we're happy to take you in. We'll bring you up to speed and you can get started.
Nonetheless, I would suspect there are some qualifications. I mean, I would guess you're looking for bilingual speakers, particularly folks who can speak Spanish. What else?
Yes, so we need individuals who can speak Spanish. If you have any computer skills, we're happy to take you as well. If you're interested in being a teacher, the fact is that these people are here to stay. They're our neighbors. They're going to be in our ESOL programs, and we need people who are not only teachers but also tutors. So we're looking for every single level of expertise to come in to support us.
One of the things you guys said in the paperwork I was looking at, quote, we help people adjust to life in New York City. In what ways do you guys do that?
So there's an application that they process, and that's called NYCID. And once they receive that, they may be excited that they have that, but then what does that mean? So what we do is we offer them places that they can go. So they're interested in visiting the museums, learning the culture. And so that's what we do. We make sure that we give them all of that information and empower them to make sure that they have this information that they can then make a decision and taking their families to all of these institutions that are available to them.
And there are many good ones for sure.
Yes, they are.
How many volunteers, Christina, do you have? And ideally, how many more do you need?
Well, right now we only have about 40 or so coming into St. Teresa. So we can bring it up to about 60 or 80 for the month. That'd be fantastic.
And I'm guessing, and you can both answer this, that in the end, the volunteers say to you, man, I get as much out of this as of anything that I do all week. That the blessing in the end is not only for the help that they're offering, but the help that they get and the blessing for themselves. Do you hear that often?
Absolutely. And at the end of it all, it's all about growth. It's all about, at the end of the day, when you put your head down to rest, you're saying, I did an impact. I was able to provide support or service to someone. And who doesn't feel good about that?
Is this call for volunteers the result of the influx of migrants, or because you're seeing volunteer turnover? Or perhaps a little bit of both.
It is definitely a little bit of both, but the influx of migrants is probably the biggest driving factor for us. And you know what, to just build upon what you were saying, that, you know, what the volunteers get back from this, you also get to just learn so much more about your own neighborhood. I think learning about the resources that are in your own community is extremely empowering.
We're going to take a break. When we come back, I'd like you to enlighten me and enlighten the viewers a little bit about how volunteers balance their commitment to doing what you're asking them to do, while at the same time meeting the needs of their family, meeting the needs of their professional life, because a lot of them, I'm sure, have jobs as well. So we'll talk about that when we come back here on Tiempo. We continue our discussion with the good folks at the Catholic Charities of New York and their volunteer outreach to help asylum seekers when we come back. Welcome back to Tiempo. With the influx of asylum seekers now in our area, many organizations are reaching out to help in any way they can. One of those organizations, our good friends, the Catholic Charities of the Archdiocese of New York, they're looking for volunteers to help welcome asylum seekers. And educating us this morning, Tessa Graham and Christina Perez from the Catholic Charities of the Archdiocese of New York. How do you go about, Christina, making sure that the volunteers are able to balance their professional life, because I'm guessing many of them have jobs, while at the same time adhering to the commitment that you've asked them to make in terms of volunteering?
We always make sure that we have flexibility in our schedules. You can jump in and be trained up on Monday, but if you can only come back on Thursday, that's perfectly fine. Our teams at places like St. Teresa's are fully committed to making sure that we have a space that our volunteers can grow and can connect. And we understand that there's times where you have other things that have to be done.
Yeah, and I'm guessing the more volunteers that you have, the more flexibility you also have in terms of filling the holes, if you will, of shifts in the morning, shifts in the afternoon. Yes?
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah, they come and go, and we make sure that we are flexible and we're just open to whatever it is that they need also. So we work around their schedule.
Christina, I'm going to ask you the same question that I asked our guests in the previous segment. With the influx never ending, so it seems, how do you and the staff and the volunteers keep from being overwhelmed? Here you're trying to help, and yet there's more people at the door on Tuesday than there was on Monday, and there's more people at the door on Wednesday than there was on Tuesday. Whew.
I think that really just comes to, you know, you really digging down deep into your own heart and knowing that you're there to actually make a difference. You're there to make an impact. And the fact is that you can see the change directly in front of you. There's there's no part of there where you're wondering, like, am I actually making a difference? You actually see that. You talked so much about, like, the hope and the love and the compassion. I think that's what makes our location so unique.
And the team also works together to support one another. So if I say, do you have this? Like, do you have my back kind of? I'm kind of tired. I need to take a 10-minute break. We make sure that we do that for one another also.
If people are watching Tiempo and you've convinced them, okay, I want to sign up, I want to help out, I want to be a volunteer, where can they go for more information?
Go right on the CatholicCharitiesNY.org website, click on volunteer, and we have plenty of options for you to select.
What will you see there?
You're going to see everything from helping us at our legal clinics. We need volunteers to be able to review some hard paperwork. We have people who do tutor work with our migrants, and we have people who are helping at the front lines with our case management team.
Yeah, because we've talked a lot about St. Teresa's and the volunteer work and the efforts that are going on there, but I'm guessing that across the board with Catholic Charities of the Archdiocese, there's a need for volunteers everywhere.
Absolutely. And the fact is that these people are now our neighbors. They're going to be touching our lives in every single program and every single facet and way. They are here to stay, and we are here to help them to the very end.
Thank you for helping them out. You guys are doing God's work, as they say, within the church, right? Thank you very much for educating us on all the good stuff that's happening there with the volunteers. And sign up. They need you.